worry can add 1 cubit to his growth. For your heavenly Father knows that you have need of all these things. But he says, but ye seek the kingdom of God first and his righteousness, and all these other things be added unto you. So you see, there's no need for us to worry about tomorrow. We are not promised tomorrow. We live in the present here in this life. We live for today only. And you know, I don't think that Jesus is saying to you and to me that we should not prepare for the future. That's not what he's saying to me. But I do believe that Jesus is saying that worrying about tomorrow will bring sadness to us in the present. Jesus' disciples faced the future. They were filled with fear because they thought they might fail. Jesus gave them encouragement for the promise and the Great Commission that it would be with them always, even to the end of the world. People are afraid to face death, yet we all must. But you know, there's even joy in death. Jesus brings joy into death by assuring us, promising us, and giving us assurance that he has gone to prepare a much better place for us when this life is over. Jesus thought in terms of bringing joy into the hearts and lives of people as being one of his primary motives for coming into this world. He wanted to bring joy. Jesus said in John 10:10, I am come that they might have life and that they might have it more abundantly. But you know, in order to have joy in your life, in order to have a more abundant life, you must have Jesus in your life. You must let Jesus be born in your life, in your heart. And you must let him live in your house, the house of your life. You want to know the fullness of joy. You know, as I told you Sunday, you are a parent. And when your children were born, you know how you felt after the pain of the labor. And I'm sure that Judy will vouch for this, and all your parents will. After the pain of labor, your heart is filled with joy because you look and you know what that you have brought into this world, a new life. That baby, and I don't care who it is, where it is, that baby that you bring into this world will change your life one way or the other. That baby makes a difference in your life. So can the baby born in the manger in Bethlehem make a difference in your life? Life is different because of the baby that was born in the manger. Everybody does not recognize the baby that was born in the manger as being the same man that died on Calvary's cruel cross for our sin. Everybody does not know him as their personal Savior. But life is different to everybody because of him. Everybody, life is different because of Jesus. Because the baby was born in the manger, there are benefits that we all, everybody in the world can benefit from. We have such things as the moral codes and the civic righteousness standard. We know right from wrong. We know if we are doing the will of God or if we are not doing the will of God. We know if we are doing something that we should not be doing. There is concern for welfare of children, hospitals, old age homes for people, welfare agencies and things like that. The light of the world shines on those that believe as well as on those that do not believe. Everybody has a better place to live because of Jesus. Whether you realize it or not, the baby, God's only begotten Son, makes a difference. He makes a difference. And I hope this Christmas, that before Christmas is over, that every one of you thank God for that gift, for that baby. You know, I told you this, I think, last year, but I believe the best gift that I ever got for Christmas was my daughter. It was only a letter, but she told me how much she loved me. And that meant more than anything else that I could ever get. And that's what God does. When he lets Jesus come into your life, he is letting you know that he loves you more than anything else. And that's all that matters. As Tommy and Mary and Tracy come with her hymn, if you're here tonight, and the baby Jesus hasn't made a difference in your life, he will. He can. He wants to. Let him bring a little joy in your life tonight. Let him bring the love of God in your heart tonight as we stand.
36.